When the war began between Germany and the Soviet Union, the Germans were attacking Turkey's longest known enemy in its history, without involving Turkey directly into the conflict. Turkey was neutral during the war, but I shall present an alternative scenario. What if Turkey joined the Axis in the summer of 1942, before the Battle of Stalingrad? In order for this scenario to occur, the Turkish president would have to be removed and replaced by a member of a more pro-German political group. Germany would offer parts of Greece if Turkey were to enter the war on the Axis side, and some additional concessions would be made, specifically in northern Iraq, parts of Syria, and in the Caucasus. Although I don't think that Germany would let Turkey get any major oil fields in the Caucasus region. Germany would also promise some modern equipment, although none of this would be provided. Germany simply had none to spare. And now, let's see the Turkish army in the summer of 1942. Turkey's army was good for World War I standards, but awful for World War II standards. In October of 1940, there were 220,000 men plus 190,000 reservists on 3-week notice. So the army was actually quite large in terms of manpower. Lots of machine guns, light and mountain artillery, but great deficiency in heavy guns. Turkey formed its first tank battalion in 1940. They had 130 Renault Air 35 light tanks and around 300 armored cars, many of World War I vintage. If you take account the thousands of modern Russian and German tanks fought in the battles until 1943, we can state that the Turkish armed forces were non-existent. The Turkish Air Force capability is similar like its armored capabilities. It had around 300 airplanes, but they were all obsolete. Now towards the actual offensive. I believe that the Turks and Germans would have tried to coordinate a simultaneous offensive in the Caucasus region. As German Army Group A, so the 1st Panzer Army and the 17th Army, move towards Baku via Grozny, the Turks would strike from the western direction. Their armies would take heavy casualties, but continue to make steady progress. While Soviet General Staff would have had intel about the incoming Turkish attack, they wouldn't have any real reserves available to stop the Turkish infantry divisions. Turkey is close to the Baku oil fields, and a combined German-Turkish attack from the west and the north could capture those oil fields, from where the Soviet Union gets more than 90% of her oil needs. Capturing those areas would greatly reduce Russian industry production and fighting capability. Germans could receive required oil for their industry and army needs. Assuming relatively limited commitment of Turkish troops in the Caucasus, the biggest effect of Turkey's Axis membership would have been indirect. Freedom of transport through Turkey affords the Germans potentially jumping off points into Iran and Iraq, where the British Commonwealths were holding down their own oil supplies with meager forces. Consider that Rommel's Africa Corps was relatively small and had constant supply problems. Should the Germans deploy a similar force in Iraq, supplied through Turkey, the British would have to increase their commitments to Mesopotamia. Germans could invade Iran and stop American help from this route to the Soviet Union. With major Soviet oil fields in Azerbaijan lost and Lend-Lease supply line up from Iran eliminated, the Soviet Union might initiate separate peace talks with Germany.